Hello students, welcome to the class on lead editorial. And this today's lead editorial, I will be dealing with a very important issue, the issue of right to privacy. Right to privacy. Now this is very important from GS paper 2 point of view, plus this is also important from GS paper 4 point of view, plus this is very important for public administration optional students, political science optional students, plus sociology optional students. Now what is this right to privacy, and why there is so much of hullabaloo about this right to privacy? Before we understand the concerns being raised and why this right is being invoked so much these days in the public debate, before we understand all this, it is important to understand a human being and a human and its relationship with the state. Now, first of all, a human is born free. Human should have every right to exert the way he wants in the society. He is free to choose whatever he likes. He is free to act as per his own wishes and desires. And a human being, because is a creation of the nature, he should also be entitled to the free privileges available with his birth. And what are these free privileges? Privileges to wander, privileges to speak, privileges to keep the things secret that he wants, privileges to keep the things private to him, means the privilege to have a sort of privacy. क्योंकि आदमी का जन्म जो हुआ है वो एक नेचर की वजह से हुआ है. मैन इज द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ द नेचर. बट व्हाट वी आर हैविंग इज दैट व्हेनेवर अ ह्यूमन इज बॉर्न, व्हेनेवर अ चाइल्ड टेक्स बर्थ इन दिस वर्ल्ड, ही इज एक्चुअली नॉट फ्री. देयर आर सर्टेन कंस्ट्रेंट्स, देयर आर सर्टेन रिस्ट्रेंट्स around a human being, around a child who gets birth in this world. Now what are these restraints and constraints that I'm talking about? कौन सी चीजें एक जो बच्चा जब पैदा होता है उसके आसपास वो गिर जाता है. Now when a human being is born, he actually gets an identification. He actually gets a certain categorization. And that categorization is known as that he becomes a citizen of any country. And when he becomes a citizen of a country, there is a kind of a tacit and indirect and tenuous relationship between citizen and state. Now there is a kind of an intangible relationship between the citizens and the state. And there is also a subtle agreement that is not actually visible. We don't have the documents for that relationship. We don't have a documents for that agreement. So there is actually a tacit agreement between a citizen and a state. Now what is this agreement that I'm talking about? Now every citizen is required to live in a way that a state desires. What is the meaning of this? It means that a citizen must give some of his rights and freedom in order to seek services from the state. Agar aapko state se services chahiye, if you want some sort of privileges from the state, and in order to get those privileges you must give away some of your right and your freedom and your privileges to the state. And if you will be giving your rights and privileges to the state, only then the state will be taking care of you. So this is a kind of a tacit relationship that is existing between a human being who gets categorized as a citizen, because there is an implicit relationship between a citizen and a state. जब एक citizen और state का relationship समझा जाता है, सबसे important चीज़ उसमें ये है कि जो citizen है, एक अच्छा state वो गिना जाता है जो citizen के minimal rights लेता है, minimal rights, not the maximum rights, because citizen is born as a human being. He is a creation of the nature and he must be free. He must not be bound by the dictates of the state. So a good state is a state which takes away the minimal rights from the citizens. So it is the duty of the state to protect the citizens in order to provide them privacy, in order to provide them opportunity, in order to provide them rights, in order to provide them freedom, in order to provide them autonomy. So this is the basis of a relationship between a citizen and a state. Now coming back to right to privacy. Now when it comes to right to privacy, as per this editorial, this right to privacy is getting tossed. Like I have told you in the beginning, the relationship between a citizen and a state is created out of compulsion to have a civilized society, to have a society in which everyone's behavior is controlled. अगर इस तरह का relationship exist नहीं करेगा citizen और state के बीच में, तो हम जिस तरह का हमारे पास सोसाइटी होगा उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम्स होंगी. हर कोई अपना फ्रीडम एक्सरसाइज करेगा. तो फ्रीडम को काट दो, बहुत ज़्यादा फ्रीडम को नहीं काटना है. जो स्टेट्स ज़्यादा फ्रीडम को काटेंगी अथॉरिटेरियन एंड डिस्पोटिक स्टेट्स होंगी. नाउ कमिंग बैक टू राइट टू प्राइवेसी अगेन, अभी जो स्टेट है, स्टेट को सिटीजन्स के राइट्स को प्रिजर्व करना है. स्टेट्स मस्ट, गुड स्टेट्स आर द स्टेट्स विच कन्फर लॉट ऑफ फ्रीडम टू द सिटीजन्स. But along with conferring those citizens, the state is able to ensure good system of governance. Not good governance I'm talking here about. Good system of governance in which the state is able to provide services to the citizens. But of late, what is happening? The way the government is functioning, the way the private sector is functioning. Because human being should be given a lot of freedom. There should not be any restraints. Because if you will be looking at what a citizen is doing, he will not be able to utilize his potential. Very important thing this is that I'm talking about. If the state will be peeping at what a citizen is doing, if a state will be peeping at what is unfolding out of a citizen, he will not be able to utilize his potential. But presently what is happening, because we are in an age of technology, we are in a state where everything is controlled by machines, everything is controlled by sensors and by computers. And these sensors and this technology and these computers, they work only if you will provide your personal information. We get access to numerous free articles. We get access to numerous free downloads of songs, movies, etc. But at the face, it seems to be that the entire thing is free. But that is not the reality. The reality is we give away our rights of, we give away our right of, rights of privacy. Not only right, rights of privacy. Numerous rights of privacy we give away. We tell the world about everything, about our mail addresses, about the phones, about the photographs in the mobile phones, about our entire call log, about our contact list and about our location. So just to get these free books, just to get this free downloads, we give away a lot of information. And this information acts as a gold mine. And this information acts as a gold mine for the corporate sector, so that they can use intended advertisement. INTENDED. Intended advertisement. So there is a kind of incursion, there is a kind of entry into your private life, and your privacy no longer exists, and you are no longer able to utilize your potential, and you are no longer able to be free. So this is very, very important. So the state must design such laws that it don't take away the right to privacy. This is very, very important for the fullest of the realization of the potential of a person, of a human being. Though it is important to have this kind of a relationship, that is between citizen and state, but this relationship don't mean that the state should try to take away everything that a citizen possesses. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. Now you can also order online video class packages on BrainyIAS.com, and you can also install the application IAS Buzz. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.